We hope the following information will be useful as your child moves into their new Year 3 classroom. These are the staff that will be working with your child this year. Mrs Clements and Mrs Parkin are the class teachers and Mrs Tickle is the class teaching assistant. Mrs Clements works the first half of the week and Mrs Parkin works the second part of the week. Mrs Tickle works each day with your child. Some other staff who may work with your child are Mrs Watson, the music teacher who works on a Tuesday, Miss Marsden, the nurture teaching assistant, and Miss Park, who offers support to all of our families in school. There are various ways that you can communicate. There's parent mail, there's a website that has all the up-to-date information. You may find the weekly newsletters useful. The school telephone number, which you will already know. Dojos are a great way of contacting the class teacher. Mrs. Parkin and Mrs. Clements will be on the class door each morning and after school. This is a great time to catch us if you need to speak to us. We're always available. Please keep us up to date with any changes to your details, particularly when mobile phone numbers change. It's really important that we do have two emergency contacts, so please contact the school office if these need updating. Drop-off and pick-up times are, there's a staggered start in the morning between 8.45 and 8.50, home times at 3.20. Just a reminder that you can enter school at the main front entrance or there is the gate at the back of the school field. The Year 3 classroom door is situated at the front of school in the preschool playground between the Year 1 classroom door and the preschool.
School uniform should be worn in school at all times, either black trousers, black skirt or a black pinafore. T-shirts should be a white polo shirt. This is your choice whether they have the school logo or a completely plain. Sweatshirts or cardigans should be navy. Again, there are some available with the school logo if you would like these. Shoes should be black and sensible that are appropriate for running around on a playground. During the summer term, if you'd like your daughter to switch to a blue and white check dress, this is absolutely fine. Our PE days this year will be on a Monday and a Thursday, and we do need to wear PE kit on those days. Joggers, leggings or shorts should be black. T-shirts should be white. Again, there are logoed T-shirts available from the school office if you wish. Jumpers or cardigans should be navy. Trainers should be worn for PE lessons. All items should be plain without writing or logos on them. Please remember no jewellery on PE days and particularly earrings. It's really important that all PE kit and school uniform has your child's name in them so that we can keep track and help if they go missing. Anything your child brings from home will be kept in their own locker. Therefore, bags should ideally be quite small, just enough to fit book bags and perhaps a lunchbox if your child has a packed lunch rather than a school dinner. It's really important that they bring a water bottle each day in case they get thirsty and that they should only contain water.
Please keep us up to date with any developments or changes regarding medical details for your child. If your child has asthma, their inhaler will be accessible to the child in school. It is the parent's responsibility to check the expiry dates on inhalers and to organise any replacements when necessary. Medical forms are available from the office if any medical information needs updating. If your child has a cough and you would like them to have cough sweets, please remember that these must be handed to the teachers for safety reasons and should not be stored in book bags or coat pockets. The drop-off is 8.45 and between 8.45 and 8.50 in the morning, and lessons do start promptly at 9 o'clock. It's really important that you phone school by 9.30 in the morning if your child is going to be absent. This should not be done via the class dojo and a phone call must be made to the school office. Mrs. Hankin was unable to give any authorised absence for holidays during school term time. Please do let us know if you are going to go away. Please book your holidays during planned school holidays only. Any persistent absentees may be may have the attendance team get involved. Be punctual every day, and just note that if the attendance does fall below 95%, then you will be contacted to discuss this further. Home time is at 3:20. Please be on time to collect your child.
Reading books in year three, we will send home two books with every child. One of these books will be a banded reading level book so that it is the appropriate level for your child with the correct vocabulary and options for questions. The second book will be a free choice book from our class library. They may choose a fiction book or a non-fiction book, and the level may not match completely to their reading level. This is so that they may choose to either read the book themselves or they may want to share that book with an adult at school. The children in year three are expected to change the books themselves with guidance and support from adults in class. Anytime you think your child has finished reading their book, just remind them that they can ask any time in school and we will allow them to change their book themselves. We will continue to send reading records home so that parents can sign so that we can see how often the children are reading, and in case you have any extra questions about reading for us to check. Please read as often as you can with your child, as the better reading readers they are, it will help with all their education. If you would like any more advice or information about reading, you may see our videos about this on the Lancaster Lane YouTube channel. If when it is your child's birthday, you would like to donate a book to class to add to our library, there is a list of recommended books available, and we will share this early on in September via the Class Dojo page. In year three, rather than teaching the daily phonics lessons, we move more on to the teaching of the spelling rules. This continues to build on from their previous phonics knowledge and is still in keeping with the Red Rose phonics scheme. Mrs. Hankin has provided more information about phonics on the Lancaster Lane YouTube channel, so please check there if you would like to see how this builds. In year three, we will send home a half-termly spelling list that can usually be found stuck into their reading diaries. This is made up of the year three common exception words that we would like the children to have learnt how to spell by the end of the school year. Any extra rehearsing of these at home will be helpful, as this will help them to build on their knowledge and help them to pass any spelling test that we do in class. One way that you may choose to practice spelling at home is through the website of Spelling Shed, and the children will have already been given login details earlier in their school career. We will send these home again at the beginning of the school year, just in case they have been lost. As across school, we will continue to pitch work appropriately that will both support children's learning and challenge them further. If we feel it is necessary, we may provide intervention groups. This could be through groups or on a one-to-one basis. This will help us to provide that extra support to children, either to challenge them further or to help them if they are finding things a little difficult. Each year, meetings take place between teachers to help with the transition, to keep everybody up to date with the needs of the children and any information. These meetings have already taken place, so we'd like to think we already know a great deal about your children, but of course we will get to know them further as the year goes along. Another place that is available in school is the Nest. This could be used on a daily basis or just the occasional time that we send children there. There's lots of extra support available in there to help with learning or just their health and emotional needs. We will keep you up to date if we decide to use this room, or the children may themselves just let you know when they have been down to visit.
Our curriculum and statements can be found on our school website, telling you a little bit more about the subjects we teach in school. The school uses power maths during their maths lessons, and we also teach weekly Happy Minds lessons. Here you can see an overview of the learning through the Year 3 classroom. This shows just some of the learning that is planned. There are a wide range of clubs and activities after school. Details of these will be available on the school website. We do ask that you fill in a letter of consent for any after school clubs, and these will come out in by a parent mail. Occasionally some cancellations may be needed to be made. We will always inform you of these via parent mail. We do expect regular attendance from your child, and if for any reason, if on a particular week your child is unable to attend, we do ask that you message your class teacher to let them know.
If you require some help with extra care for your children, we have the breakfast club available before school for an early drop-off. This is from 7:45 to 8:45 and costs £3.50 per session. If you need a little help after school while you're still at work, Stoppers is also available from 3:20 until 5:45. This is £8.20 per session. These sessions can be booked online, and if you would like any more information, you may contact the office or Mrs. Tickle, who is the manager of these clubs. We do have a parental code of conduct at school. If you ever have a little worry or a problem that you're unhappy about, your first point of call would be to come and talk to Mrs. Clements or Mrs. Parkin, as we will always try to do our best to help. Obviously, if you are still requiring some extra support, you may also speak to a senior leader in school. Particular reminders concerning the parent code of conduct would be surrounding social media. We would respectfully ask that you use this sensibly and not for complaining. The correct way is to use staff in school. If you would like more details of the parental code of conduct, please visit the school website, as it is available there.
We are a healthy school, and we ask that any water that your child brings in their water bottle is clear water only, without any flavours added. During morning snack time, your child may bring in a snack to have. This should be fruit or vegetables only. No snack bars should be brought into school. If you'd prefer your child to have toast, this can be provided by school at a cost of £1 for the week and should be sent in on a Monday morning, please. As we've mentioned before, we have the birthday books when it's your child's birthday, and no longer ask that you send sweets in on these days. We hope that you found the information that we've shared useful, and as always, if you have any questions or anything you feel that is necessary to share with us, please do let us know.